To the U.S. political scene now in the presidential election campaign, Michelle Obama is giving Democrats a stark warning about Donald Trump. The former First Lady's fiercest attack yet on the U.S. president is the headline-making moment from the opening night of the Democratic National Convention.
Donald Trump is the wrong president for our country. He has had more than enough time to prove that he can do the job, but he is clearly in over his head. He cannot meet this moment. He simply cannot be who we need him to be for us. It is what it is.
The convention, always a made-for-television political spectacle, but this is right now more of a television production than it is a live event. So this is reaction among Democrats to what they saw last night, 2 hours of campaign videos, testimonials about Joe Biden, live speeches and pre-recorded appearances. Watching from Toronto is our Megan Fitzpatrick, and she's leading our coverage of the convention for the Democrats this week, Republicans to come next week. That speech from Michelle Obama, the headliner of the night, and what a scorching attack she made on the U.S. president.
Yeah, she was the closing argument, you might say, Heather, but a lot happened before we got to her speech. So let's go over some of the highlights. The theme last night was We the People, and there was a heavy focus on racial justice in the United States. And one of the notable moments came when there was a video appearance by George Floyd's brothers. George Floyd, of course, the black man that was killed by a white police officer. His death sparked protests around the world. They called for people to carry on the fight for justice. They called for a moment of silence to honor their brother and others. There was a video of Joe Biden talking to social justice advocates. They were activists. They were really trying to draw a contrast between Donald Trump and Joe Biden on racial justice issues. Then another big focus last night was the pandemic and Trump's handling of it. There we heard attacks on his handling of it from people like Andrew Cuomo, the governor of New York, his state obviously very hard hit by the pandemic. Also hearing from Michigan Governor Gretchen Whitmer. And then there were also moments from regular Americans. There was a woman who appeared on video who talked about her father dying of COVID-19, how her father was a Trump supporter, and how he felt betrayed by Trump. Take a listen to what she said.
My dad was a healthy 65-year-old. His only pre-existing condition was trusting Donald Trump, and for that, he paid with his life.
It was one of those sort of mic drop moments, Heather, that really kind of got people buzzing, clips of that circulating, and kind of showed that throughout the night there was a mix of sort of regular people and also bigger names. And some of those bigger names included Republican names. Part of last night's agenda featured endorsements for Joe Biden from Republicans like John Kasich, the former Ohio governor who ran against Trump for the 2016 nomination for the Republicans. And then one of the other keynote speeches before Michelle Obama came from Bernie Sanders, of course, the runner-up in this race, who gave his full weight of support to Joe Biden. He was talking about how Trump is leading the U.S. down a path of authoritarianism, he said, calling Trump a threat to democracy. He urged his supporters, his progressive supporters, to get fully behind the Biden-Kamala Harris ticket. Here's some of Sanders.
We must come together, defeat Donald Trump, and elect Joe Biden and Kamala Harris as our next president and vice president. My friends, the price of failure is just too great to imagine.
And then came Michelle Obama with her very powerful speech. It was pre-taped. That one wasn't live. In her remarks, she painted a portrait of the United States, Heather, saying that the country is underperforming, not just on policy, but in its character. She picked apart Trump's presidency, saying he's causing chaos. He's sowing division among Americans, that he lacks empathy. And she also had this stark warning for Americans.
If you think things cannot possibly get worse, trust me, they can and they will if we don't make a change in this election. If we have any hope of ending this chaos, we have got to vote for Joe Biden like our lives depend on it.
And you gotta vote was one of her main messages last night as well, Heather. She did not name President Trump specifically, but she said there are people who are lying about the security of ballots and using other tactics to discourage Americans from voting, and she pleaded with them not to fall for it.
Bernie Sanders, John Kasich, Michelle Obama, that's a pretty tough trio to follow. So what tries to follow that tonight on night two?
Night two, the theme is Leadership Matters. We will be hearing from former President Bill Clinton. He's likely to talk from his firsthand experience of being in the Oval Office and make the case for why he believes Joe Biden should be the next one to occupy that office. We'll also hear from Joe Biden's wife, Jill Biden. And then we will also hear from Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez, who, of course, a strong voice from the progressive side of the party, a New York congresswoman. And she's quite likely to echo a lot of what we heard from Bernie Sanders, again, trying to get the progressive wing on board to fully support Joe Biden.
Megan, thank you very much. Megan Fitzpatrick, part of our CBC News team, covering the Democratic National Convention.